Hi, I'm Martin Grabowski and welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we'll discuss how you could implement integration tests for your API endpoints in ASP.NET Core application without any deployment. In this video, we'll take a look at general concepts of integration testing, library which could be used for integration tests, example of tests, and advanced settings for integration testing. Integration tests ensure that our components work as expected at a level which includes file system, database, and network. At the same time, you need to understand that in contrast to unit tests, integration tests use the actual component which app uses in production without any mock dependency. It requires more code and data processing, and it takes longer to run. Integration tests evaluate an application on the broader levels than unit tests. Unit tests are focused to test isolated components. Integration tests confirm that two or more components work together to produce the expected result. It's good that Microsoft provides a native libraries to implement integration tests for our API endpoints without any third-party dependency. Let's try to put everything into practice. Here we have an API project. It contains one controller, its payment controller, with one endpoint to create a payment. Logic is pretty simple. Here we are just returning our response model and information about payment with payment ID and payment amount. Also, we have integration test project. We are using XUnit as a test framework and client assertions for our assertions. The first thing which you need to make is to implement some API client which will call our API. Here it is. We have HTTP client, we are making a standard POST request, and we are serializing our response in case if our status code is successful. The next step is to install Microsoft library which we will use to implement our integration test. Here is the name. The main idea of the following library is to operate with such infrastructure components as a test web host and test server, and provides an HTTP client which we'll use to access our API. The major component from the following library is Web Application Factory. We need to create our own application factory and pass information about our program class. I propose to create several integration tests for our scenario. At first, let's take a look into our request model. It's pretty simple. It contains one property amount and it has a range data annotations from 1 to 1000. And here it's our integration test class. Here we have our iClass fixture with our web application factory. It's injected via constructor. Then we need to call a create client method. It will create an HTTP client, and this HTTP client will be used to access our API. And currently, let's create one positive test case and one negative test case. For the positive test case, we'll use a valid data. So we'll pass amount 1, and also we'll pass amount 1000. It's two acceptable values. Let's create our request model. Let's call our API client. And let's write some assertions. First assertion that result should not be null. Second, we could check that status code is successful. Then we could check that our response model is not null. Then we could check that our payment ID is not empty. And our amount is the same as we have in the request. Okay. And let's create a negative test case. So we could use the same structure. Is not valid. Let's use the error and the following one. And our assertions, it will be that result should not be null, and status code is bad request. And currently I propose to execute our tests. All tests were successfully executed. Sometimes there are situations when we need to customize our web application factory. One of the practical examples is to have isolated app settings for our integration tests. By default, when we implement integration tests, our app settings from API project will be copied, and sometimes we need to have isolated files. And due to this one, we need to extend a custom web application factory. So at first, we need to have an extension for our iConfiguration builder here. I'm getting environment name, and then I'm stopping a base path and adding one JSON file for app setting JSON, and the second JSON file with environment variable. And here we are placing two files in integration test project, the first one and the second one. Then we need to go to our web application factory, and we'll need to rewrite one of the methods. So we need to rewrite configure web host method. We'll need to call configure app configuration method. And call our new extension. So using the following implementation, you'll be able to use isolated configuration files. Also, there is one more additional method which could be useful for your customization. It's named builder configure services. So in the following block, you will be able to customize all your services which are registered in the iContainer. For example, you could remove some service descriptor which is related to your DB context for anti-framework, and for example, use the in-memory database, and also you could use it for more complex situations. Now you know how to implement integration tests for your API endpoints in a ASP.NET Core application. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe. I will be also grateful if you support my channel on the Patreon platform. Link is placed in the description.